it's its birth that has been embedded inside itself. That is known as sangraha. So these four principles are governed by genetic factors, your food habits, your physical habits, as well as it is included in your medical history. What are all the drugs that you have taken? What are all the injections that you have advocated? Sedatives, somnolizers, drowsifiers, heavy doses of antibiotics, any intra-uterine surgery for your mother. All of these factors are very essential for preparing the balance sheet of the cognitive ability of a person. Who is doing that now? Unless a person does this, it is very unimaginable. We can read CT, IT, BT and NT only in papers. So, these blood supply, as well as the other biological things I have now explained, they require a medical approach. So biotechnology must not be only a medical study, but also the person must be medically studied so that he can be qualified to get into medical study. And information technology is not only studying the information for technology, studying about the process of the real information by which he can get the technology inside. That internal information technology must also be studied. The nano level of processing of a person's knowledge and enthusiasm into practical vision must be studied before studying that nanotechnology. Real IT, BT and NT is located inside, without developing which external education that gives no meaning except some interim benefits like salary, promotion, transfer, etc. Then there are some exercises. There was a research conducted by some research institutes in which they say that you must be continuously active. What they say, in order to keep your brain alive, active and free from the hazards of loss of memory or crooked memory or anything, you must be continuously active. And according to me, up to my knowledge, only terrorists are active, so 24 hours a day. And I have never seen some productive personalities being active. So we are also active, we are doing a lot of things, but unsystematically. Number one, there are a lot of games like the billiards, polo, golf and other things. They are all white collar exercises. They don't have any utility at all. That is a status symbol. And number two, because it is a status symbol, if you are in a cosmopolitan society, if you say that you don't know billiard, you will be just look like a lizard. And second exercises like swimming, running, jogging. You have been seeing a lot of people running in the early mornings. Hardly distinguishable from pickpocketers or victimizers. It happened at Coimbatore when hundreds of people, they have been just moving in these jogging exercises in the early morning in the race course road. And two great pickpockets with gold and jewels, they are also running with them. Hardly distinguishable. I don't know the reason whether the pickpockets are looking like those highly respectable persons or the respectable community is looking like pickpockets. I don't know why they are hardly distinguishable in that crowd. So these type of exercises, they activate only the body. Running, swimming and jogging, they activate only the body. They are second status exercises. Third status exercises, they say, like chess. Like Sudoku, everybody will be seeing in most of the plays I have seen while traveling. Everybody is busy in writing numbers. Even if they have maintained their accounts very properly like that, they would have succeeded a lot. The concentration that they have, even with Sudoku and word power, crossword puzzle. These type of exercises, they say that they are in narrow band. In recent research, what they are told, these type of exercises are mastery in chess and mathematical puzzles and crossword puzzles, they are in narrow band. They are all having multifaceted covering. For example, anybody playing chess, they can understand mathematics and logics, but they have to apply, na? But just before mathematics session or lesson or workshop or examination, 2 hours, if you play chess and come and sit inside, what you can do? It gives you a provision. Because there is a chessboard. Chessboard includes 5 skills. One is attention. Attention is of 2 types. You are attentive towards your movements as well as the movements of the opponent, and you are trying to build an interrelativity as well as position analytical understanding between both of our movements. So personal understanding, opponential understanding and interrelative study and challenge analysis is there. And number two, it gives you lot of patience. To play in chess, you cannot do that. Carrom board, somebody asked me, what is carrom board and what are all they planning to do? You are just a newcomer. Then they told that they have to make all the coins to fall in the pits. It is very simple. You can just just invert the board and everything will pass. Why they are playing like that? But there should be an order, there is a proper way, and there should be patience. So chess gives you patience. And applying these qualities in mathematics or in logics, that will give you benefit. So what they told is, there are a lot of white collar exercises, which is just a social prestige. Physical exercises, they do not contribute for cognitive development. Whatever you develop as skill developing, like mathematical puzzle, word puzzle and chess, they are insufficient. So now this Cogni drill or this Cogni tip or this Cogni beneficial systems that we now recently developed, they are told that whatever you have in the society in the form of exercises are insufficient. Or those things are imbecile to develop the demand. Either to develop an inner demand or to meet an outer demand. Yes, I should develop my knowledge. It is my inner demand. Nobody is compelling me. The office is saying, we have to finish these things within 5 days. That is the target and time fixation. That is an external demand. Whether we have inner or external demand, that should be met by a specialized cognitive drill by which, according to them, there is no exercise at all, according to Western science, to develop the necessitative level of cognitive skill. There is no exercise available. But it is not so. We have to presuppose in either, we cannot write it in neurobiology or neuropsychology, but we can write it in some departments of mystics or some department of what we call consciousness technology. In that faculty, we can bring 10 exercises, 10 different exercises for meeting all cognitive demands that are existing and emerging or about to come or not even in the plan of conceptive thinking of humankind. So 10 exercises we can develop. Whatever we are having, avritti, shrinkala, ekadhyana, uccharana, anuccharana, these type of traditional practices, 10 things certainly we have to address in a seminar and immediately print it and give it to people. Whether they use or not, that is a secondary thing. So according to Western science, cognitive fitness is possible only by a new designing of a software which can give you cognitive training. That is the conclusion, that is the 2009 January 12th conclusion of the Western community. If you want to meet the demand, if you want to meet the emerging demands, if you want to be highly fitful, whatever that you have now is totally not going to come for rescue. So the only way is to have a software for assistance. Now they have made a software, DriveFit software. It is used in UK, USA, Poland, Finland, all more major countries they are using. It is a DriveFit software. It is for driving. What a great thing. Huh? Driving is a common thing. Now cooking, CookFit software. And taking care of pets, PetFit software. Taking care of your children, ChildFit software. Whatever that was there in your inheritance, whatever that was there as a product of your civilization, whatever that was there as a product of your collective existence and iterative behavior, now everything is coming in the form of software. Is it a development or underdevelopment? Can you say with conscience? This DriveFit consciousness, they have given lot of things. That is ambidexterity. To maintain both the legs in the same way. To maintain both the legs in a different way. Up and low position, low and up position. To simultaneously press something. That is ambidexterous. Unidexterous is just pressing the clutch and releasing the brake. Then releasing the accelerator and pressing the brake. This we are doing without any software. What we want is care and vigilance. Is there any software for care and vigilance? Instead of developing care and vigilance, then that is optical vigilance. Optical vigilance is understanding rain, snow, mist, then glacier, then rock slide, mud slide,